हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी विल सॉल्व पेस्ट टेस्ट ऑफ मैथ फॉर प्लस टू क्लास स्टूडेंट्स. सो लेट्स बिगिन. फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, इफ अ मैट्रिक्स ए इज बोथ सिमेट्रिक एंड स्क्यू सिमेट्रिक मैट्रिक्स, देन इट इज़ पॉसिबल ओनली इफ ए इज अ जीरो मैट्रिक्स. सेकेंड क्वेश्चन, इफ ए बी इज इक्वल टू सी, matrices B and C are of order 3 by 4, then order of matrix A is. Now because AB is equal to C and order of B is 3 by 4 is equal to, and order of C is equal to 3 by 4, so clearly order of A is equal to 3 by 3. Next question, number 3. A matrix having m rows and n columns with m is not equal to n is said to be a rectangular matrix, because for rectangular matrix m is not equal to n. Next question, number 4. The determinant of a skew symmetric matrix of even order is, let us take one example, 0, 0, minus 2 and 2. Now find out determinant of this matrix, we get 4, that is a perfect square. Next question, number 5. If A is invertible matrix of order 3 and determinant of A is equal to 5, then determinant of adjoint A is, by using adjoint A is equal to determinant of A raised to the power n minus 1, that is 5 raised to the power n minus 1, n means 3, 3 minus 1, that is 5 raised to the power 2, 5 square means 25. Next question, number 6. If A and B are invertible matrices of same order such that determinant of AB inverse is equal to 8, and if determinant of A is equal to 2, then determinant of B is. AB is equal to 8, that is 1 by A and B is equal to 8. Now determinant of A is equal to 2. Now by solving this, determinant of B is equal to 1 by 16. So this is right option for this. Next question, question number 7. If A is equal to cos theta, sin theta, minus sin theta, cos theta, and A adjoint A is equal to KI, then K is, first of all, adjoint of A is equal to cos theta minus sin theta, sin theta and cos theta. Now multiply A and adjoint A, we get 1, so KI is equal to 1, that is K is equal to 1, so this is right option. Next question, number 8. If 2x 5 8x is equal to 6 5 8 3, then x is, now solving these determinants, 2x square minus 40 is equal to 18 minus 40, 40 40 cancelled, x square is equal to 9, that is x is equal to plus minus 3. So so this is right option. Next question, question number 9. If A and B are skew symmetric matrices, then the matrix AB plus BA is. Now, because A and B are skew symmetric, so A dash is equal to minus A and B dash is equal to minus B. Now take transpose of this, which is equal to B dash A dash plus A dash B dash. Now B dash is equal to minus B and A dash is equal to minus A plus A dash is equal to minus A and B dash is equal to minus B, which is equal to BA plus AB. So AB plus BA transpose is equal to AB plus BA. So this is symmetric matrix. Next question number 10. If delta is equal to A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33 and A1j is cofactor of Aij, then the value of delta is given by option 4. Next question number 11. If omega is a complex cube root of unity and A is equal to omega 0, 0 omega, then A raised to the power 100 is equal to. Now first of all find determinant of A, which is equal to omega square, because A raised to the power 100 is equal to omega raised to the power 200. Now omega raised to the power 3 raised to the power 66 multiply by omega raised to the power 2, because omega raised to the power 3 is equal to 1 raised to the power 66 omega square, this is 1 and omega square, and omega square is equal to A. So this is right option. Next question number 12. Given 2x minus y plus 2z is equal to 0, x minus 2y plus z is equal to 0, x plus y plus lambda z is equal to 0, then find the value of lambda such that the given system of equations has infinitely many solutions. Now, determinant of A is equal to 0, because these equations have infinitely many solutions. So, 2 minus 1, 2. 1 minus 2, 1 lambda is equal to 0. Now by solving this determinant, we get lambda is equal to 1. Next question number 13. If A is a square matrix such that A square minus A plus I is equal to 0, then the inverse of A is. Now pre-multiplying by A inverse minus A inverse A plus AI is equal to 0. This term is A minus I plus A inverse is equal to 0. That is A inverse is equal to I minus A. So first option is right option. Next question number 14 and 15 are based on properties of determinants. You can easily solve these. Answer of 14 is minus 1 and answer of 15 is 0. If you have any query regarding these two sums, then ask me in comment section. Thank you.